On behalf of the University, I'd like to extend a very warm and sunny welcome to this congregation here in our Barony Hall. Our graduations are key highlights of an academic year, and we are really pleased that after a two-year gap, we're able to resume these in-person ceremonies, and we're delighted to have with us our graduates who haven't yet had the opportunity to walk over the stage and have their achievements recognised in front of their family and friends. Now, in a few moments, it will be my privilege to cap each of our graduates. I will raise the graduation cap above their head, thereby effectively conferring their degree. The capping tradition has its roots in ancient China, and it's recognised as a mark of achievement and as a rite of passage. And once our graduates have been capped, they are now part of a community of scholars at the University of Strathclyde that can stretch back over 200 years to the Scottish Enlightenment. So they're in very good company. At the close of graduation, we have a reception in our nearby learning and teaching building to which everyone is invited to come along and have some refreshments. This normally depends upon the weather, but I think looking at the weather today, we've won a watch and the academic procession will definitely take place. So I do hope that you enjoy the ceremony, and when you see your loved ones come on stage to receive their award, I would encourage you to celebrate. These occasions don't come round very often, and in this particular occasion, we've been waiting some while, so please take the opportunity to make the most of it. I now formally declare that this congregation is open, and I invite Dr. Susanna Boyle, Associate Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, to present our graduates to receive their awards. Thank you.
Vice Principal, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for research in the Department of Chemical and Process Engineering, Mohammed Geith Musa Abdul Jalil. Sarijuddin Ahmed Mohammed Alzin. Odira Vanush Atui. Precious Okochu Oti. Darius Doliaskai. Zhou Men Su. For the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Chemical and Process Engineering, Nicole Corby. In Advanced Chemical Engineering, Duncan Singer. In Process Technology and Management, Harry Stephen Fraser. Thomas Howe. Joshua Anthony Kelly. Rasmus Skiba Jurgensen. For the degree of Master of Engineering in Chemical Engineering, Umar Abdu Rahman. Tiffany Louise Aitken. Yeah. Rebecca Olden, Christopher Michael Akari, Jamie Drummond Arnold, Martin Johnson Atta, Jessica Sarah Bagley, Keir Bailey, Jennifer Bain, Lachlan David Backey, Rachel Elizabeth Black, Henry James Graham Brewster, Andrew Robert Brown, Emma Margaret Burke, Patrick James Eric Cameron, Lewis Mackenzie Cartwright, Nicholas Ian Clark, Strachan Clark, Nicholas John Clemente, Andrew Call, Stuart Conroy, Claire Conway, Alistair Harper Robertson Cooper, Andrew Crusher, Stephen Dalton, Matthew Dehan, Lucy Dempster, Hal Strahan Dami, Helen Neve Donlevy, Harry Edward Ellicott, Christina Espinosa Cancino, Matthew Nathaniel Farquhar, Lewis John Ferguson, Kristen Emma Forrest, Callum Hugh Fraser, Cara Gillen, Andrew Mark Hadfield, Stevie Hall, yeah. Emma May Hamilton. Rebecca Janet Hamilton. Aaron Matheson Hammer. Megan Jane Harvey. Ross Hay. Emma Catherine Holden. Stephanie Jane Hughes. Grant Hutton. Matthew Sean Jenkins. Sophie Ann Keane. Adam Dillon Kemchill. Jordan Alexander Kerr. Heather Kilpatrick. Fraser Gordon Knox. Sophie Lennon. Ailey MacDonald. Ross McKenzie. Alana Ray Mayer. Adam Marshall. Joseph McConnell. Ryan McDonald. Michaela Ann McFadden. Ryan McGillagley. Sean Patrick McGarvey. Jack Robert McGird. Fiona McIntosh. Ewan John McKechnie. Brooke McDonald McKenna. James McLaughlin. Jamie Robert Melling. Jordan Peter Mooney. Lucia Mora Hurtado. Sinead Murphy. Fraser Neil Murray. Scott William Murray. Connor Connor Murter. Finlay Nelson. Maggie Law Nicholson. Jonathan O'Neill. Josh O'Neill. Jennifer Victoria Park. Reed William Patterson. John Payton. Kieran Potter. Rachel Ronalds. Mary Kathleen Rutledge. Ravi Sapla. James Rory Scott. Mohammed Suleiman Sharif. Michael David Sinclair. Marie Louise Slater. Craig Anderson Smith. Robert Aidan Story. Gregor Summers. Theo Tate. Connor Owen Tehan. Matthew John Thompson. Leon Yuling Sang. Heather Jane Turnbull. Laurie Frederick Gordon Welsh. Agred Elizabeth Wood. Finlay Wood. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering in Chemical Engineering, Shahid Saud Hamed Ulhabsi. Samira Anker. Joshua David Green. Tom Peter Douglas Stavert. Faria Ashraf. Ross Thompson Cormack. Naomi Wendy Kerr. Mansoor Mangotil Puzi Toddy. Megan Sarah Ruddy. Mohiuddin Abdullah Sheikh. Ulmukhtar Al Abdullah Said Ul Hinai. Scott Ferguson. Kieran Dennis Halliday. Lisa Helen Halliday. Alistair Lanigan. Kevin Eric Roy Mulea. Jack Sands. Christine Mectis Aklilu. Membub Mahim Hussein. Ahmed Maji Mansouri. Zorka Rati.
Vice Principal, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students. For the degree of Master in Science in Applied Chemistry and Chemical Engineering, Connor Strachan Beat Brown. Alan McIntosh Duncan. Daniel Gamester. Daniel Stephen Hart. Scott Kerr. Angus Ronald Carney MacDonald. Rory McKay. Luke Patrick McCartney. Nico Oblak. Aaron Rhys Prentice. Duncan John Ross. Benjamin Eno. Nisha Middleton. Andrew John Morrison. Strathclyde Business School for the degree of Master of Science in Project Management and Innovation, Rima Al Mershedi.
Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, and most of all, Strathclyde University's graduates, it is my pleasure to once again welcome you to this congregation, an unusual one because you've already received your degrees. However, the university was determined to offer all of our graduates the opportunity to cross this stage and to celebrate your achievements in front of your family, friends, and supporters. You have earned this opportunity through all your hard work, and you fully deserve it. Let's give them a big round of applause. In a short while, at the close of graduation, you'll be asked to join the academic procession. This invitation actually symbolises the fact you're now full members of the academic community of Strathclyde, a worldwide community that numbers over 180,000 individuals. You will now join such esteemed company as David Livingstone, the missionary and explorer, John Logie Baird, who invented television, Dame Eilish Angelini, Scotland's first female Solicitor General and Lord Advocate, Helen Liddell and Baroness Annabel Goldie, leading Scottish politicians, and the entrepreneur and philanthropist Sir Tom Hunter. Today, we are celebrating your achievements and recognise the unique challenges that have been brought about by the coronavirus pandemic. The pandemic has challenged our health systems and it has impacted on our economies, and it has changed the way in which we work and the way in which we study. However, it has also demonstrated what society can achieve when we work together, and it has placed science at the forefront of finding the solutions to the challenges we face. It was science and universities that delivered the vaccines for the COVID-19 virus in record time, and it is science, engineering, and education that will help us address other pressing issues such as climate change. In November last year, Glasgow hosted COP26, the summit of world leaders which came together to agree measures to minimise global warming and climate change. As a university community, we are very much aware of our responsibilities to reducing our impact on the planet. And this is why we've set a target to reduce our carbon emissions by 70% by 2025, and to reach net zero before 2040. COP26 also saw US President Barack Obama visit Strathclyde to speak with our students about the important role that young people will play in tackling climate change. The former president had a simple but powerful message for those who had gathered outside our new learning and teaching building. Pausing on the steps, he said to everyone to get active. Now, to our graduates who are celebrating today, each of you will have benefited from the active support of your families, friends, and supporters, and academically through your lecturers, tutors, and supervisors. For the past half hour or so, their applause has rung in your ears as you each in turn crossed the stage to receive your awards. I would now like to invite all of our graduates to show their appreciation for all the support that they have received from their family, friends, and supporters. Your success, and in turn our success as a university, is in no small part due to the efforts of our staff who are delivering our vision as a leading international technological university that is socially progressive. And you can tell a lot about the values of an organisation by looking at its roots. Strathclyde University traces its lineage back to 1796, when Anderson brought it into being, the only Scottish university founded during the Age of Enlightenment and embodying the Enlightenment principles of reason, tolerance, and equality. Anderson's belief in useful learning and his commitment to taking knowledge and using this for the greater good is the motivating force which gives Strathclyde University its momentum today. Anderson believed in knowledge for the greater good and education for all, what we would call widening access and participation. Strathclyde University is at the forefront of widening access to higher education by welcoming those with the ability to learn regardless of their personal circumstances. And 20% of our new students each year come from the most challenging areas of the country. Our ethos of useful learning continues to be relevant today as we seek new knowledge that we can readily apply to global challenges. We are a research-intensive university, determined to make a positive difference to the lives of our students, to society, and to the world. Through our groundbreaking research, we are helping to change the world for the better. Through our scientists and engineers, we are leading the development of innovative technologies that will facilitate the transition from fossil fuels to clean, sustainable energy sources, such as wind, solar, geothermal, and hydrogen. We are developing new drugs along with new manufacturing processes that will provide cheaper, more effective treatments in the fight against cancer, kidney disease, and inflammatory diseases, whilst also supporting our health services to face the challenges of health and social care and the changing demographics of the 21st century. Through our focus on entrepreneurial education, we are helping students and staff to create new, sustainable businesses, as well as supporting economic growth. We are growing Scotland's manufacturing capabilities in the Advanced Manufacturing Innovation District Scotland out at Glasgow Airport, where the National Manufacturing Institute Scotland facility, hosted by Strathclyde, is under construction. Our globally minded students and staff are also working in sustainable development and helping to address some of the inequalities in India, Malawi, and the Gambia, by establishing clean water supplies, renewable power sources, and healthcare facilities. We understand the value of working in partnership as we extend our global reach with other leading universities, including Stanford, New York University, MIT, Caltech, Nanyang Technological University, and the National University of Singapore. As a university, we are continually working to enhance our student experience, investing in our campus, as evidenced by the new Strathclyde Sports Building and the new Learning and Teaching Building. And we are investing in student mental health and wellbeing support services and placing our students at the heart of everything that we do. Our progress in these areas has been recognised in recent years, and we are the only UK university to win the Times Higher University of the Year twice, having won this again in 2019. And in February of this year, we received our third Queen's Anniversary Award for our leadership in advanced manufacturing. In recent times, we've also been named the Times Higher Business School of the Year, Workplace of the Year, and Research Project of the Year. And earlier this year, the Times Higher placed Strathclyde number 5 in the UK for student satisfaction out of 150 institutions. Researchers at Strathclyde are developing highly effective treatments for tumours which are resistant to other forms of radiation, using high-powered lasers to generate beams of carbon ions with the ability to target cancerous cells. Strathclyde engineers have secured funding from the UK Space Agency to address the problems created by space debris, which is a significant global challenge facing the space sector. And there are currently an estimated 300 million pieces of space debris that are orbiting the Earth. Professor Martin Dawson, Director of Research at Strathclyde Institute of Photonics, has been named the 2021 winner of the Global SSL Awards for outstanding achievement and his contributions to the field of micro-LEDs. And Professor Gareth Pearce of Electronic and Electrical Engineering has been awarded a Royal Academy of Engineering Research Chair to support his aerosystems research of in-process non-destructive testing for composites. And researchers in Strathclyde's Institute for Energy and Environment have recently published a technology blueprint for policymakers to help decarbonise the UK energy system and support the transition to net zero. Now, these are just some of the many contributions that have been made by our staff and our students. And Strathclyde has been increasingly recognised as a place where things happen And this is why our graduates are so highly prized by companies and organizations looking to recruit the best talent to drive their businesses forward. Our success is in no small part due to the collective efforts, talent, and commitment of our staff, the 4,000 colleagues who deliver our vision as a leading international technological university. And like me, they are very proud of your achievements. All of our students learn how to be innovative, enterprising, and creative, and they can make a real difference when they go out into the workplace. So wherever your career takes you, always remember that as a Strathclyde graduate, useful learning carries with it responsibilities that go beyond academic scholarship. And finally, let me offer my sincerest congratulations to you all once again on your achievements, and I hope that you enjoy the remainder of what is a very special day. Thank you. Concludes the formal part of this morning's proceedings, which I hope you've enjoyed and you'll take away very many happy memories. I would remind you that we do have a reception immediately after the ceremony to which everyone is invited, and I can see that the sun is still shining through the doors, so we will indeed have an academic procession and all of our graduates will be invited to join that procession. Ladies and gentlemen, could I ask for you to remain in the hall until the procession has passed and then immediately follow us over to the reception. I now formally declare that this congregation for the conferment of degrees is closed.